Hello, this is H.J. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Faxanadu! Let's leave our hometown of Fialis. Oh, wait, I can't go in there. This is the building I want to go into. Now, I've already used some of my magic on the enemies back there, so let's get some dried meat to restore my magic. 50 golds, you get it filled up about 30% of the way or so, so it's not bad. It's a lot better deal than that wizard was trying to give us back there. I think he was trying to rip me off. But anyway, we gotta get past this guy. Haha! Yeah, you saw I equipped the dagger there. Well, okay, it's not there, but it's over here. So I equipped that at the end of the episode there. So yeah, that's gonna be our main weapon. Obviously, doesn't use up any magic. That's pretty nice. Now here, we gotta use the jack key in order to get through this door. And now we can leave. So let's head on over to, well, the next town there. I love the overworld music here. I love all the music in this game, but yeah. So basically, the easiest way of dealing with these guys is to use your deluge magic and then one hit with your dagger there. Otherwise, it's going to take 3 hits with your dagger to kill them. Now, eventually, we'll need to learn how to do that because I'm going to need to conserve my magic for bosses and things like that. But for right now, we don't have a boss coming up here, so I don't need to worry about that. So, oh yeah, that thing that the little spiky guy dropped there, that's a loaf of bread. That'll restore a little bit of your health there. So you don't get completely hosed if you don't have any, like, red potions on you. But for the most part, I'm really just interested in the experience. If I can get some health along the way, so much the better. There we go. Not bad, not bad. Okay, now let's see. I'm guessing these guys are zombies of some kind? I don't know. But anyway, let's see. Get that guy to drop down. There we go. These guys are really slow, and they don't give you anything other than a little experience there. So, let's head on up here. Now, one thing that's interesting about this place is, well, it's a shop that's not in the town. But the unique thing about this shop is that it sells some really, really, really good stuff, but it's really expensive, or very expensive. So yeah, death magic, I don't think is really worth it. I mean, given the amount of time that you have to put into grind or farming the gold to get it. The magic shield, I think, is worth it, because if you block a projectile or magic spell with the shield, it reduces the damage by 90%, and that is huge. And, at least for me, projectiles are pretty hard to dodge sometimes. So, that for given my skill level, or in this case, lack thereof, that's very useful for me. So, eventually, I'll want to get that. Death magic, not so much. I mean, it is really powerful. You can, like, one-shot early bosses with it, or maybe 2 or 3 shots. But, it's not very MP efficient, so to speak. The Tower of Trunk, huh? Tower of Trunks? No. No. Okay, you want me to go over there and brutally murder dwarves? Sure, why not? Sounds like a great idea. Yellow. Yeah, let's buy some stuff. Welcome to buy! And there we get a small shield. Pretty cheap for the cost. Reduces projectile or magic damage by 50%. So that's not bad. Obviously not as good as the magic shield there, but you get what you pay for. Well, I'll just tell you, if you go east of the town far enough, you'll run into a wall there. My greatest foe! And, well, the only way to get past it is to get a mattock. And you gotta get a mattock in the tower, which is full of dwarves. Or dwarfs. Sorry. Yeah, I know. Oh, apparently, dwarfs is grammatically correct. But I always spelled it dwarves, like the Tolkien spelling there. But, whatever. So yeah, we gotta go to the Tower of Trunk, and in order to get in there, you need to have a key of jack, which I've already bought, and it's more expensive here than it was in the previous town. Next town is the town of Fourpaw. And we'll be going there eventually once we get the Mattock. Whoa! What's with your eyes, man? You thought my staring was, creepy there. But anyway, now we can get passwords. Essentially, what they do is, well, it's their way of saving your game. What it keeps track of is anything in your item inventory, all your magic spells, anything in your equipment inventory, anything in your key items there, whatever you have equipped, things like that. But it does not keep track of your experience in gold, at least not precisely. See where it says my rank there? Whenever I get enough experience to gain a level, it'll increase my rank. Talk to the guru, he will increase your rank for you. And once your rank is increased, whenever you restart your game with a password, it will start you with a fixed amount of experience in gold. In this case, once I get up to the next level, which would be Aspirant, you'll start with 1,000 experience and 500 gold. So, that's how it works. But yeah, poison jars, they're pretty much like the poison mushrooms in the Lost Levels. There. You accidentally touch one, and you'll lose some health there. Why does the doctor here have a throne like the king does in the previous town? Oh, right, he overcharges everyone for all this stuff, but it's worth it because there is no meat shop here, and we can't go back to the last town now. Once you leave, you can never go back again, even with a key. So yeah, we got a limited item inventory going here. Now, one thing you can do with the password or mantra that you get, you'll start, like I said, you'll start with 500 gold if you get the next level, right? And if you do that, you can go out, buy some items, go back to him, get a new mantra, reload, get your 500 gold back, and so on and so forth. But I think that's more trouble than it's worth. You don't get that much gold out of it. But it is a way of allowing you to sort of like hoard items like I did here and then use a password and then resell them later on to get some money after you've either lost or gained some gold from the from using your mantra there. So anyway, let's head on over to the Tower of Trunk. Okay, now at this point, I really want to conserve my magic as much as possible. I'd like to have at least 50% of it by the time I get to the boss. Preferably 75%, just to be on the safe side. So, yeah, I accidentally used my magic there out of habit. For the most part, just don't use magic unless you're running into those spiky guys there and you can't get past them otherwise. I suppose I could have jumped over that guy. Alright, let's use the Jack key here. If you didn't have the key already equipped, the door would say you need the key of Jack in order to get in there. So yeah, just be careful with these guys, and you'll be fine. You don't need to kill every little spiky that you run into. Part of the reason why I dashed to this side of the screen so quickly was so that way that little spiky wouldn't drop down the ladder there on me. Now, one thing that's interesting about this room is that if you go in and out of it, I think 4 times? I'm not precisely sure how it works, but if you do that, and then you kill all the enemies in there, you can actually win a Mattock from them, instead of going all the way through this area to the boss to win it. It's something, there's certain rooms where once you kill all the enemies, you'll get an item from it, and that's one of them. So that's your only way of getting multiple Mattocks at this point in the game. Now these guys are pretty easy. They'll always jump when you get too close to them. And then they jump over you, and you get 100 gold for killing them. So remember those guys for later, viewers, because I'm going to be doing some gold farming off-screen so I can buy the magic shield, which is really, really good. So, let's kill that guy. By the way, if you have trouble making these jumps a little bit, remember to back up it as far as you can, so that way you can build up some speed to make the jump better. Let's see, let's wait for it. Okay. What are these guys? They look like little, or big, frog creatures or something, I don't know. But wise, anyway, okay, we got that. I'd rather not lose the gold, there we go. And okay, let me just do something here real quick. Okay, I think we're all set and ready to go. For boss time! Now this guy normally would be fairly tough, because it's kind of hard to dodge each and every one of the projectiles that he shoots at you. But if you saved enough of your magic here, you can just hit him safely up there, get a whole bunch of gold, and get the mat time. Hooray! But can I farm enough gold for the magic shield and break through the wall to the next town? Find out next time on Let's Play Faxanadu! This is H.C. Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!